Cross Rocks with the Shocks. We welcome thousands of elementary school kids and welcome a high-octane Western Illinois offense to Charles Koch Arena. Welcome in to the Roundhouse. Shane Dennis, Denny Garrick with you here in this matinee. And after a rough start, Keith Adams got a couple of firsts out of the way for Wichita State.
First Shocker victory down in New Mexico against UC Irvine, and then earlier this week getting the first home victory against Missouri State. When you're trying to implement that culture as a new head coach, winning games is a great way to do it.
And individually a great way to start is Rangy Bussard. 17 points a game last year, 17 more this year.
I think we saw a little bit of a different Rangy Bussard on Wednesday, however. She was more aggressive, taking the ball to the basket, getting the free throw line 12 times. We know she's capable of stretching her game to the outside, but at her core, she is a post player and needs to operate down low.
And elsewhere, Sabrina Lozada Cabbage played only 22 minutes in her first three games combined, but she's really gone off since then.
Has really been coming on as of late. Only had two double-figure scoring games all of last season. She already has four such games this year. 16 points on 7-11 shooting, very efficient, and a gritty rebounder as well.
And Diamond Lockhart, I think, has done a nice job of being a scoring guard, but not forgetting how to facilitate either.
Perhaps Wichita State's most important player today. Lockhart will be tasked with making sure that the pace is what Wichita State's looking for. Go fast, but don't hurry, and perhaps most importantly, slow down Emily Clemens.
Western Illinois averages nearly 88 a game. We'll examine them and take a look at the starting lineups when we come back.
Introducing Dunkin's new cold brew coffee, steeped slowly in cold water for small batches with an ultra smooth, full body flavor. Discover the craft of cold brew today and keep on. America runs on Dunkin'.
Wichita State entertaining Western Illinois this afternoon. The Leathernecks at 6-2, and Denning individually, they have three players averaging right around 15 points a game. We'll get to two of them here. Taylor Higginbotham is closing in on 1,000 points, and Morgan Bloomer averages about 15 a game as well.
Higginbotham is the kind of player who great teams are built around. A very consistent scorer. She's been in double figures in every game this year. Rebounds the ball exceptionally well for a guard her size and averages nearly 3 steals per game. For Bloomer, she's capable of taking the game over with her shooting at any time. Set the program record with 89 threes last season and already torched Northern Illinois for 32 points this year.
J.D. Gravina is your head coach for Western Illinois, his seventh season there. He's got this bunch in high gear. They are 13th in the nation in scoring, senior laden. They're second in steals, top five in three-pointers attempted, made, and somehow free throws attempted and made. They come at it. You'd think they play a 60-minute game instead of 40 minutes. Wichita State will counter, of course, there with Keitha Adams. She got her first two wins out of the way, as Denning told you earlier, including her first at home the other night against Missouri State, former Missouri Valley Conference foe. There's your starting five for Wichita State. Michelle Kramer, John Fletcher, and Christy Mosley, your officials here for Schoolhouse Rocks with the Shocks. And the Leathernecks will start it with the first possession. And just like that, Morgan Bloomer bombs away, didn't go, and I would think Rangy Bussard putting it in, I would think rebounding will be at a premium for Wichita State. You want to hang around with Western Illinois, you got to rebound.
Absolutely cannot give them multiple opportunities on the offensive end. They're good enough scoring as it is with one shot.
Nothing but the bottom of the net for Higginbotham. 32 points shy of 1,000 coming into the game here today. She shoots almost 49% from deep. Rosada Cabbage couldn't get it to fall. But it looks like Wichita State will keep it on this end. I think the Shockers came out in the zone defensively Denning, but they better be active if you're going to play a zone against a team that shoots like this.
Yeah, Western Illinois is more than capable of passing the ball around the perimeter enough times where they're going to get an open look. They can spread the floor with four or five shooters at any given time.
Angie Bessard's got all four for Wichita State. She had 19 the other night against Missouri State, as consistent a score as the Shockers have had.
And one thing that the Leathernecks don't have a whole lot of is size. You figure that Bessard should have at least a size advantage down low, and if the Shockers are going to have success this afternoon, getting her a lot of touches in the post is a great way to go about it.
And Lozada Cabbage at 6'2 had a decent look a couple of times down the floor, or a couple of moments ago, I should say. So, yeah, that might be the battle to look at, the perimeter play of Western Illinois against the inside game for the Shockers.
Great job by Bessard there, altering the shot after she got beat on the back cut. Just kept the hands high and let her height do the talking.
Bessard feeling it, couldn't get that one to fall. And Western Illinois comes back trailing by one. Bit of an unforced error right there. This is a statistical abomination, really, everywhere you look when you're talking about Western Illinois. On top of the scoring that we told you about, they've had four games this year, now, albeit against inferior competition. They've had four games where they've stolen it 20-plus times.
They will trap you. They will force you into making mistakes. And on the perimeter, they're going to make you be perfect with your passes.
Was on a cabbage for a three. He had 16 against Missouri State. And Wichita State, that's not exactly their forte. Western Illinois is really good at it. Shockers only shoot it at about 28% from there. So every three that they make, they'll certainly take.
Well, they've been trending in the right direction now, Shane, though. They made 6 of 10 from beyond the arc in their last game against Missouri State. And just in general, shooting the ball a lot better.
Yeah, they had collectively had a tremendous floor game against Missouri State. Rosada Cabbage lost her balance and losing it out of bounds. Wichita State's doing a good job pounding the offensive glass. They're active in the paint.
I think Bessard's just a physical mismatch for everyone down low for Western Illinois right now, and frankly just looks to be the aggressor, going after the ball harder.
Leathernecks at this point, just 1 of 4 from three. A high degree of difficulty by Taylor Higginbotham. She's got all five for the Leathernecks.
When you can shoot the ball 49% from behind the arc and also do that, it makes it a very tough guard for anybody.
Rosada Cabbage on the high-low from Bessard. Play a little two-person game there. Lockhart, mid-range jumper. Diamond Lockhart had 10 against Missouri State.
And an underrated part of that play was Cesaria Ambrosio looked to be right in the same spot where Lockhart was looking to drive. She recognized the spatial recognition, was able to slide out of that area, give Diamond an avenue to drive.
Set shot angle three is good. When Taylor Higginbotham has got 8 points already, all eight for Western Illinois.
You have to turn her into a driver. Cannot let her get her feet set on the perimeter. She can be deadly.
Kickball with 3.5 gone by here in the opening quarter. Wichita State has come out shooting 57% on 4 out of 7. And their only three was taken by Sabrina Lozada Cabbage at 6'2", stepping her game out. Again, this is a Shocker team that shoots 28% from three, but as Denning mentioned, they shot it at a high rate against Missouri State, really virtually all over the floor, three-point, two-point range free throw.
They hadn't shot better than 40% from the field in any of their first six games, and the last two shot better than 50% from the field. So something clicked, whatever it was, in the latter stages of that New Mexico tournament and on into the home game against Missouri State.
Bessard clangs a free throw. She's normally an excellent free throw shooter, and she now is just 1 point away from 1,000 in her career. Would become the 20th Shocker to get to 1,000, and there it is. 5 points for her. Shockers out in front, 10-8. Higginbotham with all eight for Western Illinois. Ten to shoot.
That's great defense.
Here comes Kiki Thompson ahead of the field. Kiki Thompson. Thompson giving Western Illinois a taste of their own medicine, a takeaway for her.
Active hand, she was in the passing lanes and then just stripped it.
There's Emily Clemens, number two. She's on the Nancy Lieberman Award watch list for nation's best point guard. She's been quiet so far. Basically everybody but Higginbotham has been quiet. Ambrosio with a rebound. Transition three, and Wichita State is humming. Timeout, Western Illinois. Sabrina Lozada-Cabbage with a pair of threes, and after a 16.7 rebound performance against Missouri State, she's picking up right where she left off.
That was a confidence three right there from Lozada-Cabbage. In transition, didn't really have numbers, but was open and let it fly. Those are the kind of shots you take when you're feeling good.
And Kiki Thompson kind of ignited that little mini run for Wichita State, which is now a 7-point lead with a steal and the take coast to coast. She had 8 points and 5 rebounds against Missouri State.
You mentioned how Western Illinois second in the country in steals coming in, a taste of their own medicine indeed. Kiki Thompson can really be an impact defender with her quickness and her ability to get in the passing lanes.
Now, when you talk about Western Illinois and all those points, and three-pointers and free throws, you do have to point out, though, the schedule that they've played. Illinois College is among the teams they've beaten. William Woods, a non-Division I, and Chicago State twice. So you take that into account. However, the stuff that they do offensively would be hard to do against nobody, the way they shoot the ball at a high rate, especially from three-point range.
Everybody on the floor moves incredibly well without the basketball. If you just watch Western Illinois on the offensive end, all five players are constantly moving, constantly shuffling to open areas of the court. They do a very good job of spacing things out, allowing their shooters to have some room. And then Bloomer and Clemens are kind of the distributors. They really get the ball to the right places at the right time, and they score at an incredibly high level.
They will. We saw a brief look at their schedule upcoming among those Stanford and Gonzaga. So the competition will certainly get stepped up here shortly. They'll open up Summit League play December 30th. Likewise, Wichita State will open up American Conference play here in about 3 weeks or so. So Wichita State has started 6 of 9 from the floor. Sabrina Lozada-Cabbage has made both of her three-pointers. So far, so good for Wichita State, led by Lozada-Cabbage's 6 and Rangy Bassard's 5.
You could see on this last three from Lozada-Cabbage that it was essentially 2-on-4, and that's a shot that normally you would think she would probably not take, would just pull it back out, let the Shockers run some offense. But the way that she stepped into that corner three earlier in the ball game, you just got the sense that she was feeling good, and that's what you want your shooters to do when you're confident, let it fly.
If you're looking for a gift for your favorite Shocker fan, you can stop by the University Bookstore for their annual 12 Days of Christmas sale happening now through December 9th, and new sale items will be added each of the 12 days. And if you'd rather do it online, you can do that too, WSUBooks.com. If you spend over $75, you'll receive free shipping. That's University Bookstore. Extended shopping hours on Saturdays during the 12 Days of Christmas sale happening right now. And another takeaway for Wichita State. By the way, Western Illinois, I know it's still early, no steals. The Shockers have 2. And there's your first one.
That's your fault right there.
Yeah, it wasn't going to last all day, I don't think.
You can tell the Shockers, though, have absolutely read the scouting report as far as the back door cuts as Hanneman drills a 3, but they've been very well schooled on what to anticipate.
Taylor Hanneman, one of the many seniors on this team, knocks down a triple. That cuts the Shocker lead to 4. Bassard in the short corner with 10 to shoot. And boy, you're right. You got to be very mindful of all your passes. You got to have something on them. Bassard with a high degree of difficulty, shot fading away. And here come the Leathernecks back the other way. Brown trying to create a little separation from Bassard. She's got it back in the right corner. 3 straight away, no good. That was Morgan Bloomer. She's been scoreless. Long pass up ahead. Boy, you got to be absolutely sure before you make those half-court passes.
Those are the kind of mistakes that the Leathernecks are trying to force you into. They know that you don't want to operate against their setup defense, and so they will speed you up in transition. Shockers need to avoid those kind of mistakes.
Dead ball turnover, so it's not going to hurt quite as much. You get a chance to set up your defense, but yeah, you don't want to be giving away possessions. There's another three in the left corner. Bloomer's first basket of the game, and just like that, the Leathernecks are back in it. They shoot around 33-point attempts per game. And it's bombs away most of the time for Western Illinois. Ambrosio for a three, no good. Bassard with a putback, Rangy Bassard.
She is doing her work early down on the block, getting excellent post position, then parlaying that into great rebounding position. She had her defender sealed off on the inside to grab that weak side rebound.
Emily Clemens been quiet. Came in averaging 15.5 and 8.6 assists per game. There's another Shocker steal. Ambrosio, and they're going to call an offensive foul. Well, she lost it anyway, but bad insult to injury. I think they're going to get her for a player control foul. That's her first. Rangy Bassard gotten off to a red-hot start. 7 points here in the first quarter, Denny.
And you could see no one accounted for her on the backside. There was just very little block out from Western Illinois, and you can't let Bassard go unchecked down low.
Higginbotham on the drive. Somebody reached in. Angie Tompkins has checked in for the first time for Wichita State.
This will be an interesting matchup for Tompkins. She's going to be asked to guard some players on the perimeter who are not necessarily true post players. She's going to have to really contend with her ability to drive the basketball.
And they're hoping her length at 6'2 will come into play here. Driving layup is Higginbotham. She's basically countered Rangy Bassard. It's kind of a game of who can top this right about now.
Very quick on the perimeter. That was a lightning quick first step to blow by.
Bassard with a soft touch, wouldn't go. Bloomer with a rebound for the Leathernecks. They're trying to take the lead here. And Bassard snatches down the rebound. Boy, look out. Woo! Emily Clemens hanging around in backcourt, almost had a steal.
That's how they get 20 steals per game. Look at just jumping and anticipating in the passing lanes. Clemens is all over the place.
And reaching in is Higginbotham. And the other thing, too, is you can overplay if you're playing a zone because you're not necessarily guarding one particular player, so you can cover it up on the back and really get aggressive out on the perimeter.
They really extend it, and they push you well out beyond the three-point arc as far as that zone goes.
Lead's changed hands a couple of times. Shockers have led by as many as 7. Late in the shot clock, we're inside 2 minutes in the quarter. Lockhart beats the clock, wouldn't go. Tompkins kept it alive, and here comes Emily Clemens. Clemens, a senior from Iowa. Drops it off for Higginbotham into the keyhole, and they're gonna call Angie Tompkins with a grab, I guess. That'll be her first.
Well, that's her second and only a couple minutes on the floor. Kind of a ticky-tack as they got her with the hand on the hip of Higginbotham on that drive, I think. But that's going to be the question for Angie Tompkins in this ballgame. Can she hang with guarding essentially a guard on the perimeter?
Yeah, I beg your pardon. That's her second foul, and she's still in there. Bassard out for a rest. She only played, Angie, 7 minutes against Missouri State. Drive along the baseline, an air ball thrown up by Coffin, but she grabbed her own miss.
Adam Lockhart did everything right there, forcing a tough shot and then just couldn't grab the board.
Tompkins does. And they don't exactly drop back on defense either. They're looking to poke one away from you in backcourt. Shockers clinging to a 1-point lead in the final 70 seconds. Oh, really. Short jumper by Preston in mid lane, wouldn't go down. Lid on the basket suddenly for the Shockers. Three in transition by Higginbotham, no good. But an offensive rebound pulled down by Brown. Clemens a brick three. There's Wichita State for the defensive boards. Alicia Fay forward from France for the defensive rebound.
This is definitely Western Illinois' pace, though.
Yeah,
up and down, not a whole lot of stoppages. They are looking for opportunities to create live ball turnovers and score in transition.
12 of their 19 shots have been from three, but only 4 of them have gone down. And a turnover again for Wichita State. So clinging by their fingernails to a one-point lead, final 30 seconds of the quarter.
This feels like a big possession right here. If they could feel like they have won the first quarter, that would be, you just think, a morale booster for this entire team, despite the fact that it was played at the Leathernecks' pace.
Holding Western to 31.6% from the floor so far. Game and shot clock are basically identical. Maybe a half-second differential. Neither team has scored in the last 2.5 minutes. Clemens didn't get it off. There's that victory you're looking for Wichita State. The Shockers with a one-point lead after a very entertaining quarter number one on WSU TV.
Wichita State University is preparing today's students to become tomorrow's leaders. The Shock the World campaign is raising $25 million in private funds for a new home for the W. Frank Barton School on the Innovation Campus. Invest today in tomorrow's business leaders by calling 316-978-4076 or visit www.wichita.edu/shocktheworld.
Busy day and night here at Charles Koch Arena. The Shockers in Western Illinois on the hardwood. A little later on tonight, Wichita State's going to make some history in volleyball. The first NCAA regional tournament. First and second rounds here at Charles Koch Arena. Shockers in Radford tonight at 8, preceded by former conference rivals Missouri and Kansas. There's your complete bracket. High-level volleyball going on here tonight. Hope you come out and join us if you're in Wichita. History being made for Shocker volleyball.
Can't imagine there'd be any interest in a Wichita State-Kansas game to go to the Sweet 16.
No. Not like that happened in 2012 up in Lawrence or anything.
And you got not only that, the men's basketball team headed down to Waco to take on Baylor. Track and field going on here on campus as well. It is a very busy weekend in Shocker sports. And just a great time to be a Shocker fan.
Pretty solid first quarter for Wichita State. They had 4 turnovers to 5 for Western Illinois. They held the Leathernecks to 31.6 from the floor, 46.7 themselves. Hard to find fault with pretty much anything for Wichita State in that opening quarter.
Yeah, if it hadn't been for Taylor Higginbotham, Western Illinois would be in some pretty dire straits. The Shockers just did a lot of things well on the defensive end. They were able to find shooters in transition, force the Leathernecks to put the ball on the floor, and they were very active in terms of disrupting what the Leathernecks were trying to do.
Higginbotham leading all scorers with 10, Bessard with 7, Sabrina Lozada-Cabbage with 6. Lozada-Cabbage made both of her threes. She was only 5 out of 14 from distance before that first quarter. Stepped into 2 of them like she'd been making them the whole season. So good news for Wichita State there as they go 2 for 3 from distance.
Sometimes it takes an individual performance like that where a player kind of outperforms their season numbers and just steps up in a big game like this. And maybe it's Sabrina Lozada-Cabbage's afternoon.
And she'll get a rest here as we start the second quarter. It'll be Alicia Fay to trigger it in. Diamond Lockhart, Angie Tompkins, and also Jalea Preston. So a handful of reserves for Wichita State to start the second quarter. Fay, short jumper, left it short. It'll be out of bounds to Western Illinois. It'll be interesting to see where the offense comes from the second union here from Wichita State.
Well, I like the idea there, trying to get the ball into the soft spot in the middle of the zone. Fay just needs to be a little bit more aggressive, either driving it hard to the hole or just putting a little more touch on that shot.
No help defense for Wichita State, but they got away with it to start with. And 2 point blank misses from Emily Clemens. And a turnover. Boy, she's had better possession, that's for sure. In transition, 15-foot pull-up by Diamond Lockhart, no good. And here comes Western Illinois after a little scrum in the corner.
Great job by Kaufman getting on the deck. It looked like Faye was going to beat her to that basketball, but she just had the want to.
Emily Clemens, the point guard for Western Illinois, 15.5 points a game, 8.6 assists, 4 steals per game. She missed 2 layups and turned it over last time down. Kind of a Haley's Comet possession for her. That never happens. She'll go to the free throw line.
Well, she's not going to stop attacking, that's for sure. She's the kind of player who's going to keep coming at you for all 40 minutes and absolutely cannot get deterred by this slow start.
Andre Stovall picked up the foul. And much like the last time down, Denning, the help behind the person guarding Emily Clemens a little slow to get there.
And a lot of what Western Illinois is going to try and do is just isolation plays where they're going to clear out one side of the floor if they feel like they have a matchup that they can exploit, and they will let their guards drive you.
Clemens is an 83% foul shooter. She missed the second, and it looks like Angie Tompkins has just picked up her third foul. So things starting to flatten out a little bit for Wichita State a minute into the second quarter.
That will be frustrating for Keitha Adams as Tompkins just got boxed out by a much smaller player and then kind of a silly foul, reaching over the head, trying for a jump ball.
Yeah, offensive rebounds on missed free throws, those don't happen very often either. And Wichita State just can't grab the ball suddenly. Now here comes Stovall, Andre Stovall. Shockers didn't have the numbers. Well, you gotta watch out for Emily Clemens, all 94 feet.
I'd like to see Stovall just attack when she turns the corner there. That was a good screen set out front. Looked like she had a little bit of room to maneuver.
Preston deep in the shot clock. Well, a lid on the shocker basket. Rangy Bessard with a rebound and had it poked away. Western Illinois in transition. A good look underneath, but a blown layup by Merriman. Well, they're missing their share of point blankers.
Very uncharacteristic, to say the least, for the Leathernecks. These have been some bunnies, frankly, that 3 or 4 of them that have rolled off the front of the iron.
Morgan Bloomer to trigger it in. Out between the rings to Olivia Kaufman, one of the few underclassmen. Nearly carried it, nearly traveled. Prayer unanswered. Lozada Cabbage back in there, collects the rebound.
Good defense by Jalea Preston, just stayed square with her body and didn't let her get the angle. Dangerous pass.
That's it. Bessard won't go. Big collision underneath. We'll see who that goes against. Shockers have committed both fouls here in the quarter so far. And it looks like Morgan Bloomer will pick up first for Western Illinois.
It's a pretty physical game so far. There have been some scrums underneath, every rebound being hotly contested.
Pretty wide open three, knocked down by Jalea Preston. That's 3 for Wichita State from long distance.
Beautiful baseline out of bounds play set up there by the Shockers. It looked like Bessard was going to be the intended target, rolling to the cup. Everyone sucked into her, and it left Preston wide open on the perimeter.
Well, if Western Illinois is going to continue to miss open and close-in shots, the Shockers will be well served to get the rebound, and a foul on the drive by Emily Clemens. She'll go back to the line.
Here's what I'm talking about with this baseline out of bounds play. All the purple jerseys flowing into the paint, trying to account for Bessard, and no one stayed home on Preston.
Jalea Preston with her 11th three-pointer of the season. She's one of the ones for Wichita State that you can kind of count on consistently from three-point range. 2 free throws knocked down by Emily Clemens. We got ourselves a barn burner.
One of the others that you mentioned as far as players the Shockers can count on from 3 is Tamara Lee, and she is not in uniform this afternoon, still battling a hand injury.
Whistle on a foul, and now they're starting to even out a little bit. Michelle Farrow with her first personal. So 2 team fouls for Western Illinois in the quarter, 3 against Wichita State. Western did a better job of covering everything up on that Shocker inbound. Wichita State by 1, led by 1 at the quarter. Most of the starters back in there for Western Illinois now, and another point-blank miss. And good job by Wichita State not to foul that time after Clemens turned the corner. Bassard drawing a lot of attention and drawing a foul. On the floor, though, not in the act of shooting. Ranger Bassard active on the backside of that Western Illinois zone.
Anytime she's got fairly good position, you absolutely have to get her the basketball because it's going to do one of two things. It's either going to draw an additional help side defender, which will free someone on the perimeter, or she's going to have a one-on-one matchup against a likely undersized defender.
Near turnover, we'll keep it here, but boy. Now we're starting to get an up-close and personal look why they're up among the nation's leaders in steals. Guarded three from the right, wouldn't go down. Bassard tried to keep it alive. Two Leathernecks go to the deck. Looks like it's going to be a tie-up, but it'll stay. The possession will with Western Illinois. Decent look in the right corner by Preston.
Very high arcing three over the hand of a defender. And J.D. Gravina, the head coach for Western Illinois, is beside himself. He thought there was a foul on that, and he is still barking at the official down the court.
Higginbotham had it poked away by Kiki Thompson, but recovered. 4 minutes gone by, second quarter. A hesitation three knocked down by Bloomer. That's her second. Western Illinois now 5 of 13 from long distance, and they take a two-point lead.
Sometimes a good shooter can just stare you down and bury it right in your face. There's not a whole lot you can do about it, but with Bloomer, you have to do everything you can to run her off the three-point line.
Rosada Cabbage for three, that wouldn't go. Shocker offense starting to dry up a little bit, and a poor pass by Western Illinois. Good job by Rosada Cabbage to cut in front of a Leatherneck and maybe help cause that turnover right there.
Well, it was a great pass if it was intended for me, but.
You did a nice job of staying out of it. Shocker's with a chance to tie it back up again. Bassard got great position on Brown. Did she travel? I would say she took a hop step. The Western back in a big hurry, even after the dead ball.
They do not take much time getting the ball
up
the court, do they? Statistics have shown if you can get into your offense with more time on the shot clock, that leads to more points per possession. And so if you watch Wichita State men's team, they've started rolling the ball up the floor to give themselves as much time as possible to run the offense. And Western Illinois just sprints the ball up the court. It's the same principle.
Shocker is scoreless in the last 2.5 minutes. They could use a bucket. Leathernecks lead it by two. Poked away. Thompson got it back. Drew the foul. Michelle Farrow has about 5 inches on Kiki Thompson, but Farrow reached over the top, and that's her second. Right there, draped on her. We got a timeout on the floor. Western Illinois with a lid on the bucket for Wichita State leads it by two on WSU TV.
Introducing Dunkin's new cold brew coffee, steeped slowly in cold water for small batches with an ultra smooth, full-bodied flavor. Discover the craft of cold brew today and keep on. America runs on Dunkin'.
About 7 hours from now, Wichita State volleyball will hit the court. They'll take on Radford. And Denning, when you go through the American Conference undefeated, you're going to have some hardware, individually and otherwise. And there you take a look at the setter and player of the year, a couple of seniors from Newton.
Shocker's absolutely cleaned up as far as the American postseason awards go. And We had talked about whether it was going to be Lehman or Hebert for Player of the Year. It seemed like both had a fairly good argument for it. Just outstanding seasons for both at the top of several different categories statistically.
And then when you go 20-0, you got the Coach of the Year, Chris Lamb. The fifth time that he's been Coach of the Year, not a bad way to head into a brand new conference, win all 20 of them.
The architect of Wichita State Volleyball has brought this program to some previously unattained heights, and just a mad scientist who absolutely is unafraid to try anything, and just about everything that he tried worked this year.
Congratulations to the volleyball program, and hopefully a lot of people come out and take a look at him tonight at 8 o'clock in the first regional, NCAA regional, Charles Koch Arena ever. I mentioned there's a lid on the basket for Wichita State. There's a lid on Western's, too. In this quarter, both teams have combined to go 2-for-15 from the floor, and certainly making rebounding all the more important, and Western Illinois is enjoying a statistical advantage there. Maybe most importantly, getting 8 offensive rebounds for the Leathernecks. They don't need that kind of help. In Wichita State, you got to shut that off.
Yes, several different times Western Illinois has missed a bunny, and the Shockers absolutely need to grab the rebound right there and turn aside the possession. But the Leathernecks have stayed scrappy as always, getting those extra possessions, and the more shots they get, the more chance they're going to get into the rhythm that they've typically enjoyed.
Kiki Thompson doesn't get to the free throw line very often. She is at the moment 5 of 11 from the stripe. And missing both doesn't help. So Western Illinois with a 2-point lead in the ball, and the Shockers can't buy a basket. Bessard with the overplay, nearly got the steal. She got tangled up with Morgan Bloomer, last touch by Rangy. So the Shockers have now seen their shooting percentage dwindle below 35%. But Western Illinois statistically has been worse than that, but they lead it by 2. Shockers are going on a 3-minute scoring drought. Clemens traveled. Emily Clemens late in the shot clock, shuffled her feet. That'll give it back to Wichita State. That's turnover number 9 for Western Illinois.
And number 3 for Clemens. I like the matchup putting Ambrosio on her. 6 foot with very long arms is going to make it difficult for Clemens to drive.
We'll give and go and a kick ball. Good idea by Rosada Cabbage. She and Ambrosio playing catch. 17 to shoot. Just a little more than midway through the second quarter. Western Illinois can't seem to shake Wichita State. Rosada Cabbage got great position underneath and left-handed scoops it up and in. She's got 8 after 2 early three-pointers.
No deception there. She basically just posted up right underneath the basket. Lockhart able to guide it into a very small window for the easy lane.
Averaging 8 a game, she's got 8 already. Knotted up at 22. Final 4 minutes of the half. We'll have Director of Athletics for Wichita State, Darren Boatwright, as our guest during the halftime break. Steal by Ambrosio. Another turnover for Western. 2-on-2 if they hurry. Well, Banker won't go. Lozada Cabbage kept it alive, and Lockhart, who missed, came up with her own. Thanks in large part to Lozada Cabbage getting a hand on it. Lockhart will draw a foul on the right side of the lane. She'll go to the line for 2. Here's the most recent inbounds play where, as you described it, she just posted up down low.
Now we saw a play earlier in the half that was an inbounds play where Jalea Preston utilized some screen and roll action to get free. This time it was just Lozada Cabbage on a dive to the basket and had a smaller defender on her, got good position.
Diamond Lockhart is 8 out of 9 from the free throw line this year. So kind of in stark contrast to Kiki Thompson when she gets the line. Neither one of them get there very often, but Diamond Lockhart has cashed in on her. She's got 4. And Wichita State retakes the lead. Higginbotham back in for Western Illinois. She had 10 early points. To the bench goes Michelle Farrell. Also in the game, Morgan Bloomer back in there. I think defensively, Keitha Adams has got to be thrilled with what's going on for Wichita State. Western Illinois misfiring over and over.
They have been active and aggressive in the passing lanes, not letting the Leatherneck drivers get to the basket without being harassed on the way there. And frankly, Western Illinois has just missed some shots.
Rangy Bessard banks one in. She's got 9, and the Shockers are back up by 4.
Well, with Tompkins having 3 fouls, Bessard is going to have to play a bunch of minutes, and she's going to have to score a lot.
Emily Clemens misfires. It's now a 3.5-minute drought for Western Illinois.
And I'm not sure that's the shot that Gravina wanted, just a pull-up from 24 feet with 20-something seconds on the shot clock.
Bessard is the best offensive player on the floor right now for both teams.
Bad shots on one end lead to buckets on the other. It's one of basketball's axioms.
And another turnover for Western Illinois. Rangy Bessard scored 4 in a row, and this is a pretty turnaround.
Just freed enough space from her defender to give herself room to maneuver, and she is very good in that mid-range elbow area.
So Bessard now in double figures with 11. Higginbotham with 10. And a Shocker turnover gives it back to Western Illinois. WIU, 3:41 without a basket. Without a point. The Shockers have forged ahead by half dozen. They are 5 of 15 and now 6 of 16 from three-point range. Does that one get spun in? Olivia Brown's first three, another steal for Western, up ahead to Clemens. Shockers get back. Higginbotham lays it in. Her first basket since her 10 first quarter points. And just like that, here comes Western Illinois. Ambrosio had it knocked away. It'll stay on this end with 11 to shoot. Final 79 seconds of the first quarter. Jalea Preston to check in for Wichita State. I gotta say, atmosphere notwithstanding, of course you got thousands of screaming kids in here. Lozada Cabbage horses one up, block, no call. But Wichita State, to finish the thought, Denning, I think it played a really solid game against Western Illinois, regardless of what happens here in the final minute.
Well, that was a heck of a pass to find Kaufman in transition. But that aside, yeah, I think you absolutely have to be pleased with where Wichita State is at. This was an outstanding look, threading the needle for the and one.
Western goes up by 1 with a chance to make it 2. Olivia Kaufman clangs the free throw. No good. Shockers get the rebound. Boy, take it easy, Diamond. All kinds of wolves hanging around trying to take it from you. Bessard from 18. Angie Bessard going off here in the first half. Shockers retake the lead. Clemens cut off. Brown didn't want the 3. Higginbotham around Bessard. And a nice job coming from the weak side. Diamond Lockhart with a steal. Lockhart to hesitation. Banker won't go. Ambrosio, that won't go. Well, that was an expensive trip for the Shockers right there.
That is one they will probably kick themselves over later. Lockhart, I love the aggressiveness, just taking it right into the body of the defender. Ambrosio, though, has to go up strong. She got the offensive rebound right underneath the basket. I don't even know if she drew iron on the putback.
Yeah, she isn't asked to score much, but when you get those offensive rebounds in the paint, those point-blank stickbacks. She had 4 points in 29 minutes against Missouri State. Cesaria, the guard from Switzerland, scoreless so far here in the first half. Final possession of the half will go to Western. And a buzzer-beating 3 by Hanneman is how the first half ends. So Wichita State led a fair amount of that first half. It was an up and down, entertaining half indeed. Goes the way of the Leathernecks into intermission. 32-30. You're watching the Shockers on WSU TV.
Wichita State University is preparing today's students to become tomorrow's leaders. The Shock the World campaign is raising $25 million in private funds for a new home for the W. Frank Barton School on the Innovation Campus. Invest today in tomorrow's business leaders by calling 316-978-4076 or visit www.wichita.edu/shocktheworld.
Welcome back inside Charles Koch Arena, matinee, School Kids Day. Wichita State and Western Illinois playing a spirited up-and-down match. Western Illinois leads by 2 at halftime. Pleased to be joined now by Director of Athletics Darren Boatwright. And this has been a tradition for quite a while, the School Kids Day. It's nice that the kids get out to see some women's basketball.
It has been. It's the 8th or 9th year I think we've done this, and it's continued to get better and more smoothly operated each time. And something that I think that the kids in USC 259 really enjoy. And I know the teachers enjoy a day out of the classroom, so that's always helpful.
Keith Adams in the midst of her first season and on the Wichita State sideline. What during the hiring process convinced you she was the right fit for this job?
Well, experience. I think that what she did for a long time at University of Texas El Paso was very impressive and consistent. Her last year wasn't what she wanted to be. She wanted it to be there, but I think with her Midwest ties, Kansas ties, and the experience that she brought to the sideline was something that we thought was very important as we were looking at an impending transition into the American Athletic Conference. And someone that has the stability and the mentality to weather a storm and to build a program, which is what we need at this time. And became very comfortable with Keita early on.
Busy day here at Charles Koch Arena. We talked about the tradition of the kids' days and what we hope will be a tradition is NCAA volleyball here year after year. A first for Wichita State and tonight Missouri and Kansas, obviously at 6 o'clock. But how surprised were you, Darren, when you heard the committee say Wichita State's going to host this year?
Well, I was very hopeful, but I was not expecting it. So I was surprised and very happy for our program, especially the young women that is playing this year. And Coach Lamb and his 18 years here is just remarkable, the run. I mean, you can look up at the banners and see there was no tradition before he got here. And to do what he has done at one institution, one school for his entire coaching career to this point, very impressive. But as far as the NCAA tournament, I think it's just a tip of the hat and an acknowledgement to the type program that we've built here. And very, very proud of that. And now we get a chance to showcase our facilities, our campus, our community, and get to host the Jayhawks and the Tigers in Bradford. And, hopefully we'll have a great night tonight of volleyball and again tomorrow.
The weekend only gets busier from here. Of course, the men's basketball team headed down to Waco to take on Baylor. You've got track and field going on here and a potential round of 32 volleyball match tomorrow night. Just in general, a great time to be a Shocker fan.
It is a great time to be a Shocker fan and to be able to get out and support some programs maybe you haven't seen before. We've been really talking up the volleyball program all year, but our track and field program that you mentioned is another one that goes under the radar, and it's a shame that that's the case. You know, track and field is the number one participation sport in America, and we're hosting a high-quality multi-meet right here on campus, indoor this weekend, and hopefully people take advantage of that and get out to the Heskett Center and check out our track and field program. It's top-notch as well.
Well, it's just getting going. Wichita State and Western Illinois, 32-30 at halftime. Darren Boatwright, thanks for taking some time to come by and visit.
You bet. My pleasure. Go Shocks.
All right. Wichita State and Western Illinois, second half coming up. We'll have some stats, some highlights, and much more as we continue on WSU TV.
State University's Barton School of Business has a long history of producing successful graduates. That legacy will grow as Wichita State builds a new business school facility on the Innovation Campus. This $50 million facility will bring students, faculty, and business together in an environment that inspires creativity, collaboration, and entrepreneurial energy. To attract the best students, Wichita State must provide an up-to-date facility combined with an applied learning experience that will give graduates a competitive edge. Campaign is underway to raise $28 million in private funds for a new home for the Barton School of Business. Your support is vital. Invest today in tomorrow's business leaders. Contact the WSU Foundation at 316-978-4076 or visit wichita.edu/shocktheworld.
Western Illinois came into Wichita averaging nearly 88 points a game, 13th in the nation in points. I thought getting Wichita State did a nice job of corralling the Leathernecks. Only 32 points in the first half, not bad.
I think they played Western Illinois' game and beat them at it for much of the first half. They were getting out in transition, playing fast but not necessarily in a hurry, and kind of just doing what they wanted to do on the offensive end.
You take a look at the conference standings, it'll get going in earnest about December 30th or so for just about everybody. There you see UConn overall at the very top, and no real question there. Wichita State trying to get victory number 3 in a row. And the most recent American Athletic Conference honors have been released, in addition to, we'll get to Wichita State's schedule in just a little bit. Florida, the state of Florida dominating the Player of the Week and the Freshman of the Week as it pertained to this particular week in the American Athletic Conference. Rangy Bassard throwing her name into the hat to try to get the Player of the Week this week, especially the way she started in the first half. And there you see she makes the weekly honor roll in the American Athletic Conference. And we've talked about it before, Denny, it'll be interesting as we get into late December and early January, being more and more familiar with teams in the American, being in a new conference. There you see Wichita State's upcoming schedule, and at the very bottom of your screen, December 30th, that'll be their first foray into the American.
Yeah, something we talked about a lot during volleyball season was kind of a feeling out process. You haven't seen most of these teams. The coaching staffs aren't familiar with each other. The players aren't familiar with each other. And so the first time you have these matchups where it's essentially strangers going at it are really interesting to watch.
A home and home against Missouri State. There you see on the 7th, the Shockers will go to Missouri State. And then a team that Western Illinois has already played, UMKC. Shockers will see them, and then the Shocker Classic before conference play is right around the corner. And obviously once you get anywhere close to Christmas, you know, okay, now it's really for real.
Yeah, and I think Keitha Adams recognizes that there's still some time to iron out the kinks, but there's only a couple more weeks before you've really got to get set. It's go time, and I think Wichita State is kind of rounding into form just based on their last two games.
So the Shockers in the first half against Western Illinois trailing 32-30. I think they'll be pleased with the effort. We'll take a look at some of the stats and more when we return on WSU TV.
Introducing Dunkin's new cold brew coffee, steeped slowly in cold water for small batches with an ultra smooth, full-bodied flavor. Discover the craft of cold brew today and keep on. America runs on Dunkin'.
Shockers trailing Western Illinois 32-30, and our highlights are pretty much encapsulated, denning by a lot of Sabrina Lozada Cabbage early and a lot of Rangy Bussard late.
I think Rangy Bussard was operating at a level where she was comfortable. She wasn't expanding her game out beyond the three-point line, which she's capable of doing, but it's not necessarily where she's at her best. She was in that mid-range area, operating at the elbow, taking those turnaround jump shots, and I think just when she is comfortable, she's a lot more effective and efficient offensively.
The second quarter was a killer for Wichita State. They, like you said, Denning, operating on a high level in the first quarter, but only 5 out of 16, 31.3% in the second quarter. Now, they held Western Illinois down, I think, by all accounts. This is a team that shoots 44.7% from the floor, better than 37% from three. They got hot late, so that carried them over that 40% threshold from three-point range, but Wichita State needs to consistently grab some rebounds, especially on Western's offensive end, if they want to hang close here.
Now, unsurprisingly, Western Illinois relied pretty heavily on the three ball. More than half of their attempts came from behind the arc. They were third in the nation in made threes coming into the ball game this afternoon, but rebounding going to be critical. Keith Adams has harped on it all season long. The Shockers aren't small. They should win a lot of rebounding battles just based on size alone, but so much of it is want to. The Shockers have to win those 50-50 balls.
Emily Clemens, the Nancy Lieberman Award watch list point guard for Western Illinois, 0-for-7 from the floor, had 3 points, only 2 assists. She averages nearly 9 assists per game. They bottled her up well. They just need to cover up everybody else now, I suppose, too.
Kiki Thompson was outstanding on Clemens. Stayed in front of her constantly, was reaching in, disrupting her passing lanes. And when Clemens did get her steals in transition, she was just unable to finish. It was a first half to forget, for sure, for Emily Clemens.
0-for-7 from the floor, 0-for-3 from three, did make 3 free throws, turned it over 3 times, as Denning mentioned, but only those 2 assists, and that's why the Shockers are hanging around. 32-30 here at the break. We'll have the second half for you coming up right after this on WSU TV.
Introducing Dunkin's new cold brew coffee, steeped slowly in cold water for small batches with an ultra smooth, full-bodied flavor. Discover the craft of cold brew today and keep on. America runs on Dunkin'.
Here in just a couple of hours, we'll have NCAA Regional Volleyball as former foes from the same conference once upon a time. KU and Missouri will hook up here this evening at 6 o'clock. Winner of that will take on the winner of Radford and Wichita State. The winner will move on to play tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. And again, can't emphasize this enough, an exciting time to be on campus of Wichita State as, for the first time ever, NCAA first and second rounds right here at Charles Coker.
And for a long time, the volleyball program just hadn't quite been able to get over that hump as far as hosting in the first and second rounds. They had got sent to Texas, got sent to Nebraska, got sent to Kansas, and that's just daunting to have to play those kind of programs on their home floor. But now the tables have turned. The Shockers get it in their building in front of what I'm sure is going to be a raucous crowd for both games tonight. It's just going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, I look forward to seeing how many people show up here tonight. Missouri and Kansas, really, that's a contest that has plenty of intrigue of its own, let alone Wichita State's first ever foray into the NCAAs here at home. So it'll be, I imagine it'll be, like you said, raucous, not only for that Wichita State match, but I imagine pretty good turnout for the Missouri-Kansas match as well.
Yeah, early in the season, Wichita State, the facilities here, they tarped off the top sections of Charles Koch Arena for volleyball, but once the attendance started climbing up towards the mid-3,000s, they took those tarps off, and I certainly don't think they will be needed tonight. I've heard they're expecting in excess of 5,000 for both matches, so that should be really exciting stuff.
Certainly look forward to that, but we've got a half of women's basketball for you here on Schoolhouse Rocks with the Shocks Day. Wichita State bottling up, for the most part, a really high-powered Western Illinois offense. So far, so good. They've averaged 87.5 points per game. The Shockers have held them to 32 through the first 20 minutes. Rangy Bassard really had a big-time output offensively in that first half. Puts up a runner. That wouldn't go. Bassard, 13 first-half points, led all scores. Taylor Higginbotham had 12 for Western Illinois. Off a screen, Hanneman got shut down by Ambrosio. Turned away a potential three there. And a cut to the basket and a lay-in by Morgan Bloomer. That's her first non-three-pointer of the game. She has 8.
Very good pass, too, from the perimeter by Higginbotham. She had 5 turnovers in that first half, but nice job there heading the cutting Bloomer.
Was out of cabbage over her left shoulder. Wouldn't go. Bassard kept it alive. Sabrina got it back. Before she traveled, dumps it in. Was out of cabbage, has 10. Well, and Rangy Bassard just a step slow, nearly had a steal. And then goes out of cabbage with a good anticipation, knocked it out of bounds.
Well, Lozada Cabbage is going to get credit for the offensive rebound and the points, but it was Bassard who kept that offensive rebound alive. And those two figure to be a problem for Western Illinois down low.
Western Illinois about exactly halfway to their averages, both in three-point attempts and makes. Higginbotham wasn't expecting the pass, nearly lost it out of bounds. Emily Clemens to the baseline, only had 2 first-half assists. And that's no good. All Shockers underneath. I wonder how unnerving this is for Western Illinois playing in this type of situation with all the school kids going nuts. Higginbotham in the end one. Taylor Higginbotham, but not the only player that has been able to finish around the rim for Western Illinois.
She drives aggressively to the basket. I didn't think Ambrosio was in a bad position at all, and not really sure where the contact was as Ambrosio was trying to just get out of the way. But regardless, a very nice finish by Higginbotham on the other side.
Higginbotham with 15. Leathernecks extending the lead to 5. 2 minutes gone by, third quarter. Diamond Lockhart just pounding it, working on Clemens. Now Bassard forces it up, wouldn't go. Off the fingertips of Brown, but Bassard touched it last. Shockers are getting some decent looks in the paint. Just can't get him to fall.
Nothing wrong with that possession. They got the ball to Bassard right where she wanted to operate, was able to spin and face up to get that short mid-range jumper, but couldn't go down. Everything but the finish.
Clemens looking to distribute, and that one rattles home. Three-pointer by Hanneman. She's got 9 all on made three-pointers. And now this is the Western Illinois offense that we maybe expected in the first half starting to show up.
Hanneman's a big shot maker. She made one of the biggest shots in school history last year, a buzzer-beating regulation 3 against IUPUI to send that game into overtime and essentially prolong the Leathernecks season.
Sports Center top play, if memory serves. Bassard up and under, scoops it in. Rangy Bassard keeping the Shockers in it. They trail it by 6.
Well, she can't get frustrated by the opportunities where she doesn't finish. She'll have to stay in attack mode if the Shockers will be successful.
Hanneman threw up a brick but stayed with it. That's at least the second time a Western player has missed a layup but went over to the other side of the basket to gather in the miss. Off the side of the backboard, Bloomer missed, but there's Emily Clemens hanging around, getting the steal in the backcourt. Just can never relax. And they turn it into 3 as Higginbotham buries her 3rd triple.
That's a dagger.
That's a killer.
two shots that weren't close, and the Shockers couldn't secure either rebound, and then they just left Higginbotham wide open on the skip side.
So the Shockers forced to call a timeout to try to keep the roof from caving in. Wichita State's track and field multi-athletes, as Darren Boatwright kind of alluded to at halftime, opened their indoor season yesterday, and the Shocker multi-competition continues today, right now over at the Heskett Center indoor track and field facility. In the men's heptathlon, top-seeded All-American Hunter Veith, second seed Ben Johnson, along with third seed Caden Griffin are all competing for top honors. There you see Hunter Veith talking to Coach Bolt. Veith won the Valley Championship in the heptathlon last year with 5,813 points. That's a school record. Placed ninth at the NCAA indoor and competing for the Shocker women. Also in the pentathlon is redshirt freshman Kendra Henry and Carly Miles. Miles, the 2016 and 17 MVC Javelin Champions. So the meet schedule for today features a 60-meter hurdles, pole vault, 1,000-meter portion of the men's hep, followed by the women's pentathlon of 60-meter hurdles, high jump, shot put, long jump, and the 800 as well. And Hunter Veith, as we mentioned a little bit earlier, set a personal best today. So congratulations to Hunter Veith, All-American for Wichita State. So on the hardwood, now Wichita State, they saw a bunch of those shots for Western rattle around and go out in the first half. Those same shots are going down. So what's Wichita State do to counter here?
Well, I think they've done a lot of stuff right on the defensive end. It's been the offensive rebounds and the second chance points that have just devastated them. That last possession, pretty indicative of that. Clemens, one of the smallest players on the court, coming from the backside to get the rebound on that three that hit the side of the backboard and eventually the skip pass to Higginbotham for the three. It's finishing possessions. You can play well for 20 seconds, and it doesn't mean anything if you give up a bucket. So playing the whole way through and closing out a possession with the defensive rebound.
Now, Western Illinois has made two of their three-pointers here in the third quarter. They're now up to 9 for 20, a very, very respectable 45%. That's how they get you. The Shockers have kept them off the free throw line. They get you there, too. They're only 4 for 6 from the line. But the Shockers being out-rebounded and out-rebounded by three on the offensive glass, those are kind of those hidden possessions where you could get some cheap points. Wichita State just hadn't been able to cash in.
And Western Illinois typically gets those hidden possessions from their steals. They generate extra possessions for their offense, which typically operates at such a high level anyway. So they're just getting the possessions in a different way this afternoon.
Western Illinois only has 4 steals, and they have actually committed more turnovers than Wichita State. But the three-pointers have been the difference. They've made 9. Wichita State, that's not really part of their game. Got a 9-point deficit to make up. Kiki Thompson in mid lane. Good strong take by Kiki. She's got 4.
She's more than capable of taking a defender off the bounce, has the quickness to get into the lane. It's what to do once she gets there, whether she's going to distribute or take that mid-range jump shot. That's an element of her game she needs to continue to develop.
Clemens finally got cut off on the baseline after her previous 2 trips down, went all the way underneath and through. And that was a good entry feed to Morgan Bloomer. A high-low pass gives Bloomer 10 points.
Again, Bloomer typically operates solely on the perimeter. She makes her hay as a 3-point shooter, but that was a great post-up and a perfect feed, too, to the open hand.
Higginbotham quickly out on Bassard. Sabrina Lobzada-Cabbage saw that. Sees part, went right down the lane, blew the layup, fortunate to get it back. See if she can cash in. She does. Big possession right there for the Shockers. If they let that go by the wayside, Wichita State's in a bit of trouble, but they cash it in, stay within 7. All alone underneath, Bloomer blew the bunny. Little teardrop wouldn't go, but a grab out on the perimeter before the shot.
Well, that was a great cut on the other end from Bloomer to find herself all alone, but just completely blew the layup. And on the other end, Sabrina Lozada-Cabbage had the same thing happen. She was able to get her own rebound, though, and then capitalized from 18 feet.
Good timeout on the floor. Western Illinois leading 45-38. I don't know that the Shockers are necessarily teetering right now, Denning, but they certainly could use a stop and some baskets in succession. I feel like that they're getting back into the game.
It's definitely danger zone. It's at the point, 7 points, where Western Illinois is liable to make this a game in which they are in firm control. These next couple possessions are very critical for Wichita State. They need to do exactly what they have been on the offensive end, getting the ball either to Bassard or Rosada Cabbage and let them operate.
They have combined for 27 of the Shockers' 38 points. Higginbotham has 18 for Western. And Bloomer has 10 all of a sudden for Western Illinois. So Western trying to extend their 2-point lead that they enjoyed at halftime. It's at 7 right now, but again, as Denning kind of mentioned, Shockers are kind of in a little bit of a danger zone trying to stem the tide with 5 minutes gone by here in the third. Stop by the Shocker Sports Grill and Lanes, 2 hours prior to all WSU men's basketball games. Enjoy great game day specials on food and drinks. Perfect place to meet up with friends before all the men's home games. And when the Shockers are on the road, like they are tomorrow afternoon, you can catch all the games on TV at the Shocker Sports Grill and Lanes. Lower level in the Rattigan Student Center. The Shocker's been outscored by Western 13-8 here in this third quarter. It was really back and forth in the first two quarters, but Western has seen a lot of the shots that didn't go in the first drop here in the third. They're 5 out of 9 from the floor here in the third quarter.
I think for Wichita State, the question is going to be who else can step up besides Lozada Cabbage and Bassard. They're not going to win this game with those two scoring 100% of the points. Someone is going to have to make some big-time plays down the stretch to balance out the kind of balance that Western Illinois possesses.
Western has gotten a 3-point make by 4 different players. Taylor Higginbotham has hit 3. Taylor Hanneman has hit 3. And so it's not like we only have 1 or 2 players that they're going to set up and run off a bunch of stagger streams. Everybody shoots 3s for Western, so you got to honor them all.
1 through 5, they will space the floor, and then they just kind of let Clemens do the distributing. She typically makes the right decision, and they generally get an open look out of it.
So the Shockers will get the possession, down 7, quickly in the corner to Lozada Cabbage, but wisely Higginbotham, or excuse me, that was Hanneman, covered her up. It's been Bassard and Lozada Cabbage. Ill-advised skip pass attempted by Jalea Preston, taken away by Western. Brown. Now out top to Hanneman, a guarded 3. That's exactly what you want if you're the Shockers. Cover up Hanneman, who's made 3 of them. She's 3 out of 6. There's a stop we were looking for. Now let's see if the Shockers can execute on the offensive end. They looked really good the other night against Missouri State, basically from start to finish. Bassard, a step back 17-footer, went 16. Saved by Lozada Cabbage, though. And the Shockers had a couple of chances. And it looks like a foul on the rebound as Wichita State gives it back.
I like the idea of getting the ball to Bassard in the high post area, but she just never got her feet set. She was kind of fading away on that mid-range jumper. A great save by Lozada Cabbage, and Preston probably wishes she had that little floater back.
And she committed the foul in backcourt. That's her 3rd. And a 3 quickly by Higginbotham goes down, but just like that. 4 3-pointers for Taylor Higginbotham, and she leads everybody with 21 points. She is now only 11 points away from 1,000 in her career. Bassard on the feed from Kiki Thompson, and 1. Getting rangy Bassard going toward the basket is always a good idea.
And everybody on Western Illinois turned their head as it looked like Kiki Thompson was about to go into a mid-range jump shot. And so Bassard, with great awareness, able to slip back door completely unaccounted for.
Bassard, 17 points, right at her average. Her first trip to the free throw line, where she's an 80% foul shooter, and she knocks it down. Beg your pardon, that's her 2nd trip to the free throw line. So she gets the Shockers back within shouting distance, 48-41. Well, there's another offensive rebound on a blown layup by Western. That's at least 3. Kaufman gathered in her own. Shot clock did not reset. Corner 3, air ball off Bassard, and she couldn't save it. You don't anticipate air balls, and sometimes that benefits the offense, even though you threw up the shot that didn't hit any iron. Four to shoot. Higginbotham, a prayer, not answered. Lozada Cabbage, the rebound. Shockers down seven with the ball. 3 minutes remaining, third quarter.
Great job by Ambrosio there on the defense against Higginbotham. Just let her size do the work.
The blow by and the finish by Lockhart. Lockhart got around Emily Clemens, which is hard enough the way it is, but a feathery soft jump shot from 10 feet.
Well, there's going to be open space in the middle of that zone. If you can penetrate the perimeter, there will be room to operate.
Good look underneath to Morgan Bloomer, who banks it in. Bloomer's got 12.
Like I said, they all just move so well without the basketball. Constantly cutting, constantly weaving, finding the open spaces.
Good look, too, by Brown. Good job by Kiki Thompson to keep it alive. Bessard on the feed from Lozada Cabbage, blocked. Ambrosio will slow it down. Lockhart to set up the offense. An offensive foul on Diamond Lockhart. That'll give the possession back to Western. Kind of a questionable call.
Yeah, I'm not buying into that. She didn't even look like she was trying to drive towards the basket, trying to circle back out and go towards the perimeter. And
that's nothing. That's a nothing. That's
not
no call.
Much there, yeah. It wasn't bad defense. She moved her feet. She was in the right spot. I just don't see the need to fall down.
Back in there with three fouls, and Angie Tompkins picked him up in pretty short order in the first half. Ambrosio to Tompkins, had it knocked away. That's probably just as well. It was knocked out of her hands, out of bounds. Shockers get a chance to reset.
Chance for some redemption for Angie Tompkins, who didn't get to do much of anything in the first half, hampered by that foul trouble. But now needing to give Rangy Bessard a little bit of a blow, a chance for her to make an impact.
Didn't really get a lot of minutes or production against Missouri State. Just 2 points in 7 minutes the other night against the Bears. Andra Stovall checks in for the Shockers, so she'll run the offense along with Kiki Thompson in backcourt. Ambrosio, Lozada Cabbage, and Tompkins on the front line. And again, the pass has got to be a lot more crisp than that, but another blown layup for Western. Shockers hanging by a thread, down by seven. But it's been that way for a while now. Shockers have had their chances. Final minute 20 of the quarter. Ambrosio got fouled from behind after turning the corner. Not many free throws being shot by either team. That's a big part of Western's game. They've only shot six. Wichita State, 3 of 6 themselves.
That's 4 fouls, by the way, on Farrell.
Three-pointer by Tompkins, no good. And you're going to stay on this end? Wichita State will get yet another chance. Now Michelle Farrell, senior, averaging 8.5 a game, has 4 fouls for Western, as Denning pointed out. Ambrosio, wrap around to Tompkins. Force, wouldn't go. Shockers have had multiple chances to get it within 5 or fewer. And there's 4 fouls on Tompkins.
We knew once Clemens got the ball in the open court, and she saw it was essentially a one-on-one against Tompkins, that she was going to go right at her, force her to either get out of the way or commit that 4th foul. And even though it's 5-4 going up against 6-1, felt like Clemens was the aggressor, though.
Hard to stay in front of Emily Clemens when she's in the open floor in high gear. Clemens still without a basket. She's made 4 free throws and now make it 5. She's an 83% foul shooter. Third in the nation in steals with 4 a game, and also averages nearly 9 assists per game, Emily Clemens. She only has 4 assists so far here today, but the Leathernecks with a 9-point lead. Lozada Cabbage for 3. Western slowly but surely maybe wearing down Wichita State with their pace. That 3 won't go. Good closeout by Tompkins. Tompkins playing with four, but that's the way it's got to be with Bussard over on the bench getting some rest. Good look to Tompkins, who banks it in. Ambrosio with a good feed.
Ambrosio's passing has really improved over the last several games. She's been kind of the facilitator of this offense out of a point forward type spot, and a great job driving the lane, forcing the defense to react, and then finding Tompkins.
That's Tompkins' first bucket of the game. Gets the Shockers within seven. Leathernecks will hold it for the final shot. No good. So Wichita State survives an up and down third quarter. Final 10 minutes coming up with the Leathernecks leading the Shockers by seven on WSU TV.
Introducing Dunkin's new cold brew coffee, steeped slowly in cold water for small batches with an ultra smooth, full-bodied flavor. Discover the craft of cold brew today and keep on. America runs on Dunkin.
Angie Bussard leading the Shockers with 18 points. Sabrina Lozada-Cabbage has 12. Taylor Higginbotham for Western Illinois leading all scorers with 21. And Morgan Bloomer has 12. That third quarter for Wichita State, the Shockers started off slowly offensively and eventually kind of chipped away. But I thought it was the defense against Western Illinois who looked like maybe they were going to run away and hide from Wichita State.
Yeah, once that lead got extended out to 9+, you thought like Western Illinois was at a point where with a bucket or two, they could run away and hide in this game. And credit to Wichita State. They made some big-time plays to keep this deficit manageable, keep it at a point where it's not out of the question they could rally.
Catch the latest episode of On Pace with Shocker Track and Field, keeping you up to date with the latest track and field news. Shocker track and field multi-athletes, of course, opened their indoor season yesterday with the Shocker multi-competition, and it extends today at the Heskett Center. All-American Hunter Veith, Ben Johnson, Katie Griffin, all competing in the men's heptathlon. Of course, as we told you earlier, in the women's, redshirt freshman Kendra Henry from Waverly, Kansas, and Cheney native Carly Miles highlight the women's pentathlon field. On Pace previews Shockers inter-squad meet coming up a week from today on Friday the 8th. Steve Rainbow gives us a preview of the American Conference teams, a roundtable discussion on how to make track and field and road racing more popular. Watch it on WSU TV's YouTube channel. All right, here we go. Final 10 minutes of the ballgame. Shane Dennis, Denny Gehrig, our first of a busy day of sports here at the Roundhouse. And banking it in is Morgan Bloomer, and that's how the fourth quarter starts, with Western now up by nine.
I've loved Bloomer's ability to move without the basketball and just find those open areas in the defense. You have to respect her three-point shooting ability, and so that gives her a little bit of leeway to move with some freedom, and she does it very well.
Western Illinois came into this game 6-2. Kiki Thompson jumps it up from the right baseline, and it's fouled. I believe that was Olivia Kaufman. It's personal, so a pair of free throws for Kiki Thompson. So every, I don't want to say every possession, you got to have something here for Wichita State, but with the high efficiency that Western operates, you might want to cash in all the chances you get.
Yeah, no need there for the hard closeout by Kaufman. I think if you're Western Illinois, you can live with a Kiki Thompson 16 or 18 right. foot jump shot. As for Wichita State, like you said, you're at a point now where you can't really afford to have empty possessions and or trade buckets. They'll have to make a move at some point.
Thompson knocks down two big ones. She's got six. Saw the graphic a minute ago. She's not asked to score much. Only averages about 6.5. The Shockers trailing by seven. As it turned out, they basically traded baskets in the third quarter, especially in the last 5 minutes of the quarter. Little runner goes in. Emily Clemens finally scored as a basket. Clemens came in averaging 15 and a half a game. She has seven. All but that bucket from the free throw line. A turnover by Wichita State.
Well, you knew it was only a matter of time before a player of Clemens' ability finally got on the score sheet. And that was a nice step through move. On the other end, Wichita State looked like they had pretty good post position for Bassar, but the pass was right through her hands.
And Ambrosio picks up her third personal foul in the process. Each team with one foul in the quarter. Tompkins out there for Wichita State playing with four. Morgan Bloomer. That ball goes out of bounds. They couldn't get it to her. I was going to say Bloomer with 14 in support of Higginbotham's 21. So Kaufman and Clemens in backcourt. Higginbotham got off to that red hot start. She had 10 points in the first quarter. Clemens got around Andra Stovall. Thought maybe for a second Wichita State would get the possession there. It looked like she just lost it, but maybe not. Higginbotham will keep it with 12 to shoot. Eight to shoot. Clemens with the hesitation. Boy, she was cut off initially, and then Stovall just relaxed for a second.
That was a great move. The fake spin back to one shoulder and then cutting back to the left. And Stovall was leaning back towards the middle of the court. Nice move by Clemens, who's now all of a sudden made back-to-back buckets.
And now all of a sudden, Wichita State trailing by 11. There's the hesitation that killed Andra Stovall. And by that time, there's only three left on the shot clock. So you thought you had the hard work taken care of, but Stovall just relaxed for a split second. That's all it took.
Yeah, at that point in the shot clock, you knew it was just going to be Clemens having to make a play. There wasn't really time for much else. And I thought Stovall did a great job of cutting her off. And the Shockers have done that throughout the ballgame. Kiki Thompson and Ambrosio especially, using their long arms and their quickness to stay in front of Clemens. But she is crafty and did a great job there.
Well, here early in the fourth quarter, in the first 1:45, Western has made all three of their field goal attempts. Shockers haven't gotten a shot up yet. They made a couple of free throws, but I think it's now or never for Wichita State.
And I think Keith Adams realizes that, calling the timeout now, probably drawing up a play to try and isolate either Bassard or Lazada Cabbage at some point where they can operate.
So the Shockers taking timeout to try to stem the tide. This is the biggest lead of the game for Western Illinois. Again, later on tonight, Wichita State and Radford for the first time ever at Charles Koch Arena, the NCAA first and second round. We'll start it with KU and Missouri at 6. So Wichita State and Radford, the Highlanders, at 8 o'clock or 30 minutes after that first match, whichever comes first. Again, an historic night at Charles Koch Arena coming up later on this evening. Schoolhouse rocks with the Shockers. Matinee with Western Illinois today. The Shockers trying to make it 3 in a row. After dropping their first 6 inning, they had a near miss down in New Mexico against Illinois. They felt like they could have and should have won that one. Did beat Cal Irvine. And then knocked off a couple of nights ago Missouri State in very impressive and pretty much wire-to-wire fashion. Knew they'd be running into a buzzsaw in Western Illinois. They're a good program out in the summer.
And it's a style of play you're not going to see a whole lot. They are just constantly up-tempo, constantly able to shoot from anywhere on the court, 1 through 5. And an opponent like this, you can scout them all you want. You can prepare for them in practice. But until you see it up close and personal, there's just really not a whole lot you can do to prepare for it.
Now, one big thing they hang their hats on, the Leathernecks, is steals. They only have 7 here this afternoon, which is a more than respectable number, especially when you consider Wichita State has 6. Only 2 fast break points. So none of these turnovers that Wichita State has been inflicted by have really been the loose ball, run out, easy basket turnovers. But Western can get you a lot of different ways, and Shockers will be fighting uphill, trailing by 11 with 8 to go. And probably should have been a turnover there. Ambrosio looking to distribute, as Denning pointed out. Thompson to Tompkins for the layup. Angie's got 4. Big possession there for the Shockers.
Now it's all about getting stops. They will have to string at least a couple of them together to give the offense a chance to get back into this, and that's a tall mountain to climb.
Deep angle three rattles in. That's a killer. Olivia Kaufman's first three-pointer of the game. She's got five and lead back out to a dozen now.
She can be a little bit streaky from behind the arc. She's absolutely capable of going off. 24 points in a game earlier this year, but at times will just disappear. That was a big-time shot.
Bussard forces. No foul, but they'll keep it on this end. Rangy Bussard lost it out of bounds. Kiki Thompson up and banking it in. She's got 4 points. She's been playing with four fouls for the last couple of minutes.
Thompson now 6 points, six rebounds, and four assists as Angie Tompkins is trying to get involved offensively, but it's just been a slow go for her.
Western leading by 12 with the ball here in the fourth quarter. Brown stepped into a three, wouldn't go. Emily Clemens has been fairly quiet for Western Illinois, but Shockers struggling to find consistent buckets. That's going to be an and one. A call goes for Wichita State. Kind of an iffy 50-50 call, but Angie Tompkins gets the basket and the foul, playing with four. Risk reward at this point, you got to take what you can get. And Tompkins got the call and inside the restricted circle. That was the issue there.
Angie Tompkins looked like she was about ready to protest the call, which thankfully went her way.
Right.
That would have been five and would not have boded well for Wichita State. Instead, a chance to cut it back to single digits and make this fairly interesting again.
See what they're taking a look at the monitor. Here's the replay. As it looked like Olivia Brown, they were trying to figure out who it was, I guess. I thought it was fairly clear she was in the restricted area, or the area that you can't draw charges in. So it looked like all the right calls were made, and Angie Tompkins going to shoot free throws. Shoot one. 7 points for Tompkins, the lead back to nine. Clemens and one. After a somewhat risky pass near the mid-court stripe, she ended up getting it back and, in essence, went coast to coast.
A lot of teams, when facing a full-court press and having a lead, would be content to break it, pull it out, and run some offense. But that's not how Western Illinois plays. They were right on the attack, got Clemens in transition, and that's what big-time players do.
Clemens has now 12, and the lead back to 12. Clemens answers Tompkins' three-point play. Skip pass to Kiki Thompson. She jumps it up, wouldn't go. Rebound corralled underneath by Morgan Bloomer. Bloomer, 14 points and five rebounds, right about at her average. Higginbotham on the take. Yep, that was Higginbotham. Ambrosio's third personal foul, so now maybe a parade to the free throw line. Fourth foul, or a parade to the free throw line for Western Illinois. Statistically, they're not all that impressive from the free throw line, but it's the volume that kills you. They live at the free throw line most nights.
They are just constantly attacking, whether it's from the perimeter or driving to the basket. They are, and even on the defensive end, you just cannot relax or be lazy with the ball for a second. They will jump on you. It is a really interesting style that J.D. Gravina has developed here at Western Illinois.
Now the lead balloons to 14 as Higginbotham has 23. Came in averaging 15. Upper left baseline, no good. Tompkins, another three-point opportunity. Angie Tompkins has been playing with foul trouble virtually from the get-go, but she has managed to be really active and really effective here in the fourth quarter.
She can absolutely carry a team in spurts when she's playing well. She's just such a versatile scorer and does a great job of positioning her body down low. She leverages it very well to create position and space.
missed the free throw, so she stays stuck on 9 points, 4 of 8 from the floor. Been playing with four for a while now. She has four, Ambrosia now has four, Farrell with four for Western Illinois. Higginbotham, an angle three, no go. Missed everything, out of bounds. It'll stay on this end, five to shoot. Higginbotham makes nearly 49% of her threes. And even when she shoots an air ball, things work out for Western. They get one last shot at it. Great job that time by Diamond Lockhart not to go for the stop and go.
That's, yeah, she pulled the exact same move that she did on Stovall with a little hesitation with her back to the basket. And you could tell the Diamond had either read the scouting report or had just been watching intently. She was very much prepared for that move, and Preston came over too to get a deflection.
J.D. Gravina having a little conversation, a wry smile on his face with one of the officials as his point guard didn't quite have things work out for him. Corner three is good. Preston's second three. Wichita State hanging around, trailing by nine. Jalea Preston. And that one banked so hard off the glass that Western was able to corral the rebound. That three no good by Emily Clemens, so Wichita State gets the stop they need. Still 4.5 left.
Preston still hanging out in that corner, trying to get free once again.
Again, Wichita State not built to shoot their way back in it from distance. Bessard couldn't get it. What it amounts to a loose ball foul on Olivia Brown. This may have been a no, 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 yes type of three-pointer. Guarded in the corner, but nothing but net. Jalea Preston.
She can be a little bit streaky, but last year led the team in threes. She had 34 triples, and when she gets hot, she's capable of making two or three in a row. The Shockers will need every one of them down the stretch.
Shockers trailing by nine. Getting late here on WSU TV.
Wichita State University is preparing today's students to become tomorrow's leaders. The Shock the World campaign is raising $25 million in private funds for a new home for the W. Frank Barton School.
Shockers trailing by nine. Just north of 4 minutes left to go in the game. Corner three again is good. Jalea Preston in either corner. The last two Shocker possessions, and we got a six-point game. And a turnover by Western Illinois. A very uncharacteristic decision by Emily Clemens. See if the Shockers can take advantage, Denning.
Well, I think the way they're going to take advantage is just get the ball to Jalea Preston and see what she can do.
Yes, so. Shockers are now 5 of 10 from three-point range. Preston is 3 of 4. Bessard in the high post. Went with a reverse layup, wouldn't go. Boy, that would have been big.
Thought she had a step on her defender too, just could not pull the trigger, and now Western Illinois a chance to get three back.
Higginbotham banked it in. She's got 26, 5 three-pointers. Ice water in their veins. They don't care what time or score is, they keep gunning them up. Bessard got too far underneath the basket. Now the Shockers are desperate for a stop. And it couldn't get all the way back to cut off Olivia Kaufman. Five in a row for Western.
That banked in three just deflated them, I think.
Sure did.
We could see Bessard and Tompkins were both very late getting down the floor.
And Jalea Preston, with her hands to the heavens, couldn't believe that that went in. And now Wichita State teetering on the brink, trailing by 11. Time running short. Three more. Morgan Bloomer, her third triple. That's now 8 points in a row in the blink of an eye. 66-60 just a moment ago.
How quickly it can turn and how quickly this Western Illinois offense can get in gear.
Assar to put back won't go. She go to the free throw line. Ranger Bassard has 18 points and 6 rebounds. Wichita State in the bonus if they can make a little hay in the paint, but now, Denny, you would think it would be almost exclusively inside out for sure, but you're going to start looking to try to take some threes for some defensive rebounds.
And the question will be, can they force turnovers too on the other side of the ball? Clemens, who's had a very uncharacteristic afternoon with 4 of them, but in general, Western Illinois, one of the best in the country at turnover margin.
Clemens suddenly with 12 points and 7 assists. Bassard nails both free throws. Rangie's got 20, but the lead is a dozen with 2 minutes remaining. Finally, it would appear Western's going to run some clock.
They seem like they didn't want to initially, yeah. Like they were ready to pull the trigger. Almost a reflex.
J.D. Gravina, their head coach, I think, told him, do whatever you want until 3 minutes are left. Then, then we'll play normal basketball. Oh, Higginbotham with another three. She's got 29. Shockers have not had an answer for Taylor Higginbotham. She's 10 out of 14, 6 of 9 from deep. And in this half, they are 7 for 15 from three-point range. They're now 14 of 32 on threes, and they make it look pretty easy sometimes, don't they?
And how about Higginbotham, too, with 10 rebounds? She's only 5'10", but just seems to be in the right place at the right time. That's 3 double-doubles for her now out of the guard spot.
Shockers held them to 32 points in the first half, but they are closing in on 80 now, and a team that averaged nearly 88. Shockers have to burn a lot of clock. Rosada Cabbage, quick three in the corner, wouldn't go. Bloomer the rebound, and that might do it. Shockers fall back. Minute 10 left. So the Shockers' little mini two-game winning streak is going to come to a close against a high-powered offense from Western Illinois. Bassard the rebound, and she's fouled in backcourt by Emily Clemens. Took a shot to the chops. Clemens, known for this, hanging around in backcourt.
And I think they're gonna go check that at the monitor.
I'm sure they will. Gonna determine if that's a swinging elbow kind of contact. You get a 6'1" Rangie Bassard and a 5'4" Emily Clemens, and sometimes that's going to come into play. So with a 15-point lead, Western Illinois had their Nancy Lieberman Award watch list point guard, Summit preseason player of the year, hanging around the backcourt. Now, certainly don't want to excuse Rangie Bassard if they're determined that she was swinging elbows, but you could live to fight another day. Get back.
My question is, if they got the foul on Clemens, wouldn't that then mean that Bassard was just trying to clear space and that it wasn't ill-intentioned, I suppose, is the way I would describe it. But those plays are so hard to figure. The NCAA had those rules a couple of years ago where if there was any kind of contact with an elbow to the face, even if it was inadvertent, they would often call it a flagrant. They've kind of loosened up on that, but you never really know how a certain officiating crew is going to judge a particular call. See, to me, you've got Clemens reaching in and Bassard just trying to clear space, and so that you get the foul on Clemens,
right,
and you can't really penalize Bassard after that fact, but we'll see what the officials decide.
And your point is good. The call was a foul on Clemens in backcourt. That was the original call. Hey, you can stop by the Shocker Sports Grill and Lanes 2 hours prior to all WSU men's basketball games this season. It's the perfect place to meet up with friends before all the men's home games. And when the Shockers are on the road, like they are tomorrow afternoon, you can catch all the games on TV. Shocker Sports Grill and Lanes, lower level, Radigan Student Center. Here you see the drink specials at the Radigan Student Center. Shockers taking on Baylor tomorrow afternoon. A little later on here this evening, Missouri and Kansas in the NCAA first round of the volleyball tournament, followed by Wichita State and Radford. In an otherwise uneventful final 57 and a half seconds, we've had an elbow making contact with a jaw in backcourt, and that's brought things to a screeching halt.
Well, Keith Adams is over there right now talking to J.D. Gravina, and I think I was just reading her lips, and she was saying, I don't want anything to happen in the last 57 seconds, this game to get out of hand, and what has been very hotly contested and very spirited competition for the first 39-plus minutes.
Well, I don't think, and of course, purely speculating here, I don't know that anything was necessarily intentional, but the fact remained that Ramsey Bussard's elbow made contact with Emily Clemens' jaw. And so you owe it to yourself to take a look at the monitor, but as Denning pointed out, the foul was initially called on Emily Clemens. And, Sabrina Lozada Cabbage is at the free throw line.
What in the world?
Can you explain that one?
Did they eject the Sard?
She is on the bench. That's interesting. Lozada Cabbage makes one out of two. There's Ranger Bussard right there, sitting on the Shocker bench. Could it be that Keith Adams took her out?
Doesn't she have to shoot the free throws?
I would think so, yeah. That's peculiar. I don't know that I've seen that one. 77-63, final 35 seconds.
Well, they didn't call it a technical because Western Illinois didn't shoot any free throws. So I officially have no idea.
And we got no explanation over the PA. So strange days indeed. 33 seconds remaining in this one. Two free throws for Olivia Kaufman. That one's up and good. Kaufman with 8 points now. Everything purely cosmetic from here on. Going to be a Western Illinois victory. Final 26 seconds. Lisa Chappell, free throw line jumper, spins out, no good. Lozada Cabbage with a putback. Sabrina Lozada Cabbage makes it 78-65, Leathernecks. So the Shockers will keep Western Illinois under their average, but it was a strong second half by the Leathernecks. Will send them to 7-2 on the season. Shockers will fall to 2-7 and be back in action in a couple of days against Missouri State going to Springfield. 78-65, the final. We'll be back with more after this, WSU TV.
Wichita State University is preparing today's students to become tomorrow's leaders. The Shock the World campaign is raising $25 million in private funds for a new home for the W. Frank Barton School on the Innovation Campus. Invest today in tomorrow's business leaders by calling 316-978-4076 or visit www.wichita.edu/shocktheworld.
I love Wichita and I love you.
Shockers dropped this one this afternoon, 78-65, but we're just getting started as far as sports here at Charles Koch Arena. We got volleyball coming up at 6 o'clock here local time. KU and Missouri, the former foes of the Big 12, getting together. And then Wichita State plays its first ever NCAA regional appearance in Charles Koch Arena. It'll take on Radford at 8 o'clock or thereabouts. Well, the Shockers fall 78-65. They fall to 2-7. Western Illinois improves to 7-2 overall. For Denning Garrick, everybody of the production crew, Shane Dennis saying thanks for watching. Once again, Western Illinois over Wichita State on WSU TV.